hoping for a quick stab and go, but it seems the counselor might actually know something about Ulron. So Counselor Dulra does know something about Veyr's brother. Damn it all. Now I suppose you want to actually talk to her before I execute the walking pile of pond scum. Of course we do. I specifically waited for you to arrive because I figured that would be the case. Still doesn't mean I'm happy about blurring the line between helping Veyr and performing my duty as a Morog Tong. We discovered that the next meeting of the High Council will take place at the consulate outside Balmra. The War Claws and the Ashlander abuse aren't completely sanctioned by the House, and Dulra was present when Ulron was exiled. Not a bad haul. That means we have to get Dulra to spill her guts before I spill her guts. Just keep your wits about you, hero. Dulra wields her feminine charms the way I wield my daggers. Don't let her seduce you into doing something stupid before I end her. Be quick with your questions, hero. When I slip in, so do my daggers.
Ah, you must be here about those pesky patrol schedules. After all that clandestine correspondence, it's a pleasure to finally meet you in person. Now, come closer so we can celebrate our partnership in a proper fashion. Well, look at you. I'm impressed. The last person House Drez sent over was so much more scruffy. I have a meeting with House Halalu shortly, but I think I can spare a few more moments for you to seal our partnership, you understand. Oh, you do, do you? And why in Oblivion would I tell you anything about that? You're obviously not my afternoon appointment. You'd best take your leave before I have my soldiers throw you into the swamp. Ulron's dead? That's news to me. All I know is that Ulron was tested and found wanting. He decided that the life of an Ashlander was more important than that of a Redoran soldier. We stripped him of his rank and banished him from Vardenfell. Everyone knew Ulron cared more about those savages than he did for members of his own house. But what does it matter who tested his loyalty? He failed and paid the price for his poor choices. Now, tell me what this is about before I get really angry.
That's what you're wearing? All right, but it's your funeral.
How dare you! I'm a lord of House Redoran, the Morog Tong.
The Morog Tong issued the writ with your name on it. You do remember that House Redoran frowns upon slavery these days, yes? Take another look around, hero, and see if you can find anything else related to Ulron. More proof that Dulra was in bed with both House Halalu and House Drez. That's Captain Bruvin's seal. I suppose our evil counselor courted favor wherever she could find it.
Getting old is no business.
good Captain Briven appears to be more involved in Ulron's fate than I had imagined. He never struck me as the type to use murder and deceit to get ahead, but that's the problem with greed. It causes decent people to make stupid choices. Or he's trying to hide something. The letter mentioned an intact squad sent to scout the old fort. You need to get out there and see what those soldiers know before Briven gives them new orders and they disappear. If you can slip into town, sure, Veya should be told. But you didn't take my advice. You killed Redoran soldiers. That's your trouble to deal with. I need to present my completed writ, so I'll catch up with you and Veya later.
The alternative is a lot worse. That's what he said.
Yeah. Oh.